Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and I did a video on handling multiple fact tables in Power BI. I did this video a long time ago. And recently, someone posted a really good question on the video. What you created, Patrick, was a circular dependency relationship, and I can't get the data that I need at all. And they gave an example about appointments and encounters at a hospital. And so I was like, hey, let's give it a go. I love these types of questions, and we're gonna try to solve the problem. Before we get into this, there's two articles on circular dependency. And the first one is back in 2021. This is a really good one. And then in this one, the thing that I want to point out at the top, it says a circular dependency is detected whenever two objects reference each other in such a way that Power BI cannot process the objects. In my model was simple. There was a reseller-seller fact table, an online sales fact table, and I believe date was connected to both. And I just had two measures. One was a sum over sales in one table and sum in sales over the table. Nothing reference each other. But what I did was I reproduced their model. And so let me show you, right? Enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. And so let me show you what I did. Over in SQL Server, I'm using Management Studio. I created the three tables, encounters, appointments, and patients. I added some encounters and appointments, and I added a few patients, just very generic. And then I went into Power BI Desktop and I brought my model in. And I'm assuming, right, a patient can have appointments, one patient can have a particular appointment or multiple appointments, and one patient can have multiple encounters. One individual encounter or one individual appointment all relates back to a single patient. And so what I did was I just did a simple count rows to count how many appointments a person has, and then the same thing with encounters. And if we go back to the question, it says, I just can't get all the data because anytime when I drag the patient name field from the patients into the graph, Power BI can't tell if the patient I want is the appointment patient or the encounter patient. When I think about this, if I go over to Power BI and I grab the patient name, let's do this and everybody's gonna go crazy. But what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna create a new column. I'm gonna call it patient name, first name, ampersand. It's okay, it's a calculated column. I didn't do it upstream. It's okay, it's a demo. Okay, so I'm gonna bring patient name over. And for that patient on a dashboard that I create, if I drag appointments over, there's three appointments for all the patients. And if I drag the encounters over, there's three appointments for all the patients. If I choose patient one, there's no appointments for patient one, but they had some encounters. If I choose patient three, one and one. And if I choose patient two, two and zero. If I go over to Management Studio and let's copy this and add some appointments. I should have had this ready, but it's okay. I like doing videos like this. So let's just say 3, 4, 5. I don't care about the dates. Let's just do 1, 2, 3. Everybody will have an appointment now. Okay, insert this into the table. Let's run this and let's go refresh. Okay, let's find somebody that didn't have an appointment. One appointment here, no appointments for one, but I did. So let's refresh and now you can see there's one appointment. Now, this is easy because I'm just filtering and doing a count. But what if I put it in a table or a chart? And so let's get rid of this and this. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna make this a clustered column chart. So there's all my patients. And then what I'm gonna do is drag in appointments. So you can see patient one has one, patient three has two appointments, and then patient two has three appointments. If I add encounters, now it separates them up. And if I just wanna see encounters, uncheck appointments, and if I copy this and paste this, and if I wanna see appointments, and then I get rid of encounters, and then I can change the colors and I can set it up like that. It just works. So Canine Tiger, what am I missing? I'd love to know. I hope this helps you out. I gave you the scripts and the PBIX file on how to set this up, but the way I designed this model and even the other model in the other video, I didn't get a circular dependency. The important thing is the way you set this up and the way you design your DAX, because if you read those articles, you'll see if you have DAX that's referencing each other, a measure that's referencing a measure and another measure that's referencing that measure, you'll get some circular dependencies. All right, what do you think? Yeah, comments, questions, I'd love to know. Did this answer your question? You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric of Power BI, it's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, for Matt and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.